In this video, we're going to use the second fundamental theorem of calculus, that's FTC2, to solve some problems involving integrals. So the first problem is to compute the integral from 2 to 3 of 3x squared minus 4x plus 1 dx. So if you would think of this as area under the curve, y equals 3x squared minus 4x plus 1 is a parabola. And we're interested in what is the area between 2 and 3. And yeah, we could chop it up into pieces and estimate the pieces and add them all up and take a limit, but that's hard. So instead, we're going to use the fundamental theorem. The first thing we have to do is we have to find an antiderivative. So what's an antiderivative? What's a function whose derivative is 3x squared? Well, that would be x cubed. And what's a function whose derivative is 4x? That would be 2x squared. And what's a function whose derivative is 1? That would be x. So there we go. We've found ourselves an antiderivative. And then the fundamental theorem of calculus says that in order to evaluate this integral, all you have to do is take the antiderivative and evaluate it at 3 and at 2. Take the difference between the value at 3 and at 2, and then you win. So f of 3, well, that's 3 cubed minus twice 3 squared plus 3. F of 2 is 2 cubed minus twice 2 squared plus 2. That's 12 minus 2, and that gives you 10. So our answer is 10. Okay. Now, what would have happened if we picked a different antiderivative? See, the derivative of x cubed minus 2x squared plus x is 3x squared minus 4x plus 1, but the derivative of x cubed minus 2x squared plus x plus 100 is also 3x squared minus 4x plus 1. If we'd done that, then when we picked f of 3, we wouldn't have gotten 12, we would have gotten 112. And when we picked f of 2, we wouldn't have gotten 2, we would have gotten 102, but the difference would still be 10. There are lots of choices for the antiderivative. There's only one right answer. Okay, in our next problem, we want to compute the integral from pi over 4 to pi over 3 of secant squared of x dx. Well, our function is secant squared, and a function whose derivative is secant squared, you should remember that the derivative of tangent is secant squared. So, to get the integral of secant squared from pi over 4 to pi over 3, you take the tangent of pi over 3 minus the tangent of pi over 4. This involves a little bit of trig. Let's remember what the tangent of pi over 3 is. Pi over 3 is 60 degrees, so we've got a 30, 60, 90 right triangle. The hypotenuse is twice the base, and the height by Pythagoras is square root of 3. The sine is root 3 over 2. The cosine is 1 over 2. The tangent is root 3 over 1. Pi over 4 is 45 degrees. So the sine is 1 over root 2. The cosine is 1 over root 2. The tangent is 1 over 1. So up here we have square root of 3 minus 1. And that's our answer. Last problem. Compute the integral of sine of 2x from 0 to pi over 2. Now this is a little bit tricky because you might not immediately think of a function whose derivative is sine of 2x. You might guess negative cosine of 2x because the derivative of negative cosine is sine. But that isn't quite right because you've got to use the chain rule. By the chain rule, the derivative of this function is the sine of 2x times the derivative of 2x, so that's twice the sine of 2x. So can we adjust our guess to make things work? Sure. If we guess half of that, then we're going to get half of that, and that's what we want. So we found our antiderivative, and then we just plug in. F of pi over 2 minus f of 0. So that's minus a half cosine of pi, and then we subtract minus a half cosine of 0. The cosine of pi is negative 1. The cosine of 0 is 1. You plug in, you get 1/2 plus 1/2, and our final answer is 1.